AT&T Phone for Business. As the primary account owner, you can set up individual voicemail boxes for your team. Watch and we'll show you how.
To leave a message for Jane, press 1. To leave a message for Joe in accounts payable, press 2.
This is Joe in accounts payable. Please leave a message.
Using my AT&T, Jane quickly set up a voicemail box for her accounts payable department. First, Jane signed into my AT&T and created a subaccount for Joe. To learn how, watch Setup User Subaccounts. Next, Jane went to the Setup Voicemail page in my AT&T. Here's how to find it. In your account overview, expand AT&T Phone for Business. Then click Manage My Plan. On the My Phone Service page, scroll down and click Setup Voicemail. For the voicemail type, choose Advanced and then click Continue. On the Setup Voicemail pages, the steps are shown at the top of the page. The Continue button at the bottom of each page saves your entries and gets you to the next step. On the first page, add names. Label your phone numbers. Your purchase numbers are listed on the page. To label a number, just enter a name. Jot down the number you'll use for the new voicemail box. Next, on the Add Subaccount Users page, set up access to the voicemail box. To do this, choose the subaccount of the user who will have access. From the list of subaccounts on the left, Jane chooses Joe's subaccount. For the selected subaccount, enter a PIN, which will be used to access the voicemail box. On the right, choose the keypad number callers will press to leave a message. To leave a message for Joe in accounts payable, press 2. Finally, on the Add Voice Mailboxes page, link a phone number to the user's subaccount. Jane finds the number she named for Joe and links it to his subaccount. This is the last step. Click Save and you'll see the confirmation page. Time to record new greetings. Remember to update your company greeting, adding the key presses for the new individual voice mailboxes. And record the greetings callers will hear after pressing a key, inviting them to leave a message. To learn more, visit our support page at att.com/smallbizsupport.